Hi. We meet more and more orgs that have multi-currency set. So this is great for companies who have offices in different countries, but because of the cloud structure of Salesforce, still want only one Salesforce to work in. So multi-currency is of course the solution. What multi-currency brings to a Salesforce org is just one extra field to every object. It's called the currency ISO code field. So in this case, the name is opportunity currency. And because I've said in my multi-currency setup that I want to support these three currencies, that's why I have a drop-down box and I can still change the currency of my opportunity. So now, how does this work and how can you work with multi-currency and PDF Butler? What you want, of course, now is not a dollar sign or a euro sign in case of euro. You actually want to use this ISO code to put inside your document because the ISO code knows best what kind of currency you are currently working in. Okay, so let's check out that first step already. We go to a demo document, and in the demo document, what I've added here is very simple, a currency. A merge field for a currency. This is where the ISO code will sit, and of course our amount, because this is the amount we want to show. We have the currency field used two times. Only one config type is required for that, and of course we also want to put in the expected revenue. So very simple, straightforward demo that shows all of the functionality that we want to work with. Okay. Let's take a look to the setup in PDF Butler. We have created a .config. In the .config, we have added only one data source, in this case, the opportunity data source, but we made a small change in the configuration here. If we look at the data source, you will see that the amount is not of type currency, as it would be by default if you load the configuration from Salesforce. But we have changed that to number. And also the expected revenue is now number. Means that PDF Butler will not try to automatically add the ISO code, the dollar sign or the euro sign to the currency. It will just see it as a number, so you can format it as a number and select your own currency sign to be placed in front or behind of it. So in our case, we have decided here to show the currency ISO code from our record. So from the opportunity record we have just set. So very important step, change this to number instead of currency. Then we have a couple of fields. We have, of course, the currency field. This is linked to our currency ISO code field in Salesforce from our opportunity record. Then we have the amount and the expected revenue. And take a look here what I've done. I've taken the amount, and now because it's of type number, I can add formatting. I can add formatting, and this is an international approved way of formatting numbers. So you can find documentation anywhere on it online, or just follow our link here, and we have a great explanation already. A lot of people, definitely in Europe, think that, hey, a comma here between the thousand separator and a dot here for the decimal separator, that's wrong. No, in the international standard, it is like this, and it's actually the formatting that will decide, okay, are you in Europe, are you in US or in England? So this decides where to put a comma and where to put the dots, which is the decimal character to separate decimals from all of the other numbers. Why I've put 0, 0 at the end? Because I always want two digits for my numbers, because we're talking about currencies here. If you want to work with more currencies, you can of course add placeholders for those as well. So that's our placeholder. That's already clear. We do exactly the same for the expected revenue, the same kind of formatting. So we are done here as well. Let's take a look at the conversion. Click the button, it gets the data. Damn, that was fast, the document's already there. And as you can see, it's the ISO code that it selected. And the it has a comma as a 1000 separator because we're in the States. And it has a dot as an decimal separator. So this document looks great to be sent off to anybody with that trades in US dollars. Okay, I want to take it a step further now, because we now need to decide, if we continue in this demo, how to show our 1000 separators and our decimal separators. Remember that commas and those points here that I've put in this formatting string. So we now have to decide that when we change our currency to euro, then it should actually be a comma as a decimal separator and a dot as a 1000 separator. How can we do that? Well, of course, it's possible with PDF Butter. What I've done here is just a small, simple example. I've created a formula field to calculate the correct locale that I want to use. If you are not acquired with locales, what they are, you can always look it up on the internet or just contact us via support@pdfbutter.com. A locale is a combination of language and country. So by knowing the language and the country, it perfectly knows how to format these numbers. PDF Butter has the database of all of the formatting and all of the locales across the globe, and it knows how to format the numbers just like that. It also knows how to format the dates depending on this locale, so all of that is there. Let's take a look at our formula field, simple formula field. I created a case where I decide on the currency ISO code field. If it's US dollar, then the locale should be ANUS. When it's Swiss francs or euro, of course you can make this much more complex, and depending on the language and the country of your contact, your primary contact, all of that is possible in Salesforce. If you have a field that decides which is the locale, you're set, you're good to go. If you do not have a field that decides which is the locale, that's not a problem. It will just use the locale of your current user. And maybe in most cases, this is more than enough, all that you need. So now, how does it know that it has to use this field? For the ones using this Lightning component, that makes it very easy, because you can just go to edit page. And what we have done here is we have told the system that the API name, so the name that you get from here in our field definition, that this field will be used as the locale to decide which is the locale of our current user or our current customer. We are not talking in here anymore about the user in Salesforce. We're talking actually the locale of the customer you want to send the document to. Okay, so this is extremely powerful. You can now create the documents that you would like in the language and in the locale of your customer, and it will be look perfect for him or for her. Let's take a look. I've changed to euro. I changed to locale NLBA. So if I now click my button, the generation goes very fast, of course. That's PDF Butler. It now says euro, and as you would expect, the dot as a 1000 separator and the comma as a decimal separator. Always two digits behind the comma, exactly as I intended it. And next up is our Swiss. If I save it, you will see that the formula has changed already. If I run this again, of course, it will look exactly the same. It seems that the Swiss would like this kind of an accent as their 1000 separator, and also use a dot as their comma separator or decimal separator. So we knew this, that's why I took the example, but I assume that a lot of people did not really know this, how this would work. But we know this, PDF Butter knows this, and it will format it as it's supposed to be formatted for that locale. Okay, that's it. That's how to use multi-currency, multi-locale features inside Salesforce as indicated. Yeah? You can use this currency field in your on your record to choose your currency. That's this one here. So just make a placeholder for that and a config type. And yeah, the most important thing I think in this overview was that you should change the type of your data source from currency to number. Okay, that's a small overview. I think this is it.